love you. This is for you.
And now, the moment you've all been waiting for.
SMU FM 97.1, the ultimate voice, airborne. Tlotleletsa ya sedimosetsa ebile ya itumedisa SMU FM re mmogo nao reeditse
SMU FM 97.1 the ultimate voice airborne.
Dumela moretso wa SMU FM and welcome to the ultimate drive. It is a mess outside because the person that I promised you gore o tla ba teng o na le rena. And remember to hit us up on all our social media platforms at SMU FM 97.1. And our WhatsApp line is 0681479222. That's 0681479222. And in studio, I have Nasty C, who is a South African rapper, songwriter, and record producer, who was born on the 11th of February 1997. He has three albums, Bad Hair, that was released in 2016. Drinks and Blinks, that was released in 2018, and I have to say that is actually one of my favorites. And Zuluman with Some Power, that was released in 2020. He is the youngest recipient of the 2015 South African Hip Hop Awards, namely the Best Freshman Award. And in 2020, in March, he signed a joint venture with Def Jam Records, and he released his first United States song. Literally, guys. People are making me nervous.
I'm sorry.
It's titled There They Go, which gained him global recognition. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Nasty C is in studio.
Oh my gosh.
Ladies, hi, baby. Guys, hi, baby. No, that wasn't right. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, Nasty C is in studio. He's hyping himself again. People are hyping him outside. You guys are in here. You're not hyping him. Welcome to SMU FM.
Thank you. Thank you for having me. So good to be back.
So good to be back. But not, I'm just glad that you're here. Like, I am a huge fan. So, can you please tell us about the radio tour, the campus radio tour?
Campus radio tour is just me. Pretty much just coming out here to hang out with you guys, you know. I'm doing a little tour. It's like the Baby Ivyson tour, you know. It's the Ivyson Army tour, and it's like this one is a bit more intimate than the Ivyson tour. It's not just a show, you know. It's a full on experience because it's gonna be so many different things that happen within the show itself. It's not just like artists performing on stage. You know, it's acting as artists. It's gonna be a comedy segment and stuff like that. So I figured if I'm gonna do something that different, I need to come and touch base with you guys before the night off, just so you get a sense of how chilled it's gonna be and stuff, you know? And also just to kind of read your energy. I haven't seen you guys in so long, man.
So, man, Nagin Murfala, welcome. Welcome to the Ultimate Drive and SMU FM. So, Bila Bila, there's one thing that I actually want to know. What made you come up with this thing at campus tour? What made you come up with not touring like one of the biggest radio stations, choosing the campus ones?
Because that's where I feel like my core fan base is. That's where the people that really rock with me and have grown with me since like my primary school / high school years, you know? These are the people that have been with me throughout this whole journey. So it's like, it's only right to come to them, you know? And it's like since COVID and stuff like that, people haven't really been outside. Well, hip-hop people.
Yaruta, ya tshotsheletsa ya sedimosetsa ibile ya itumedisa SMU FM re mmogo now ready.
If you wanna leave, if you don't wanna go the whole way, then we'll meet and go.
Top 10 rappers.
Yeah, that's oh,
okay.
Don't take out the USB. Don't take it out. SMU FM. You still tune into your favorite show, The Ultimate Drive, with no traffic. And I won't want to get a lot of telephone. So, some of them are like a music machine for the Mutaba is a mirror of SMU FM. And since I'm getting a lot of STC, so we're just going to discuss the top 10 best rappers in the world. And this list is by, yes, of all time. It's by Amy Clark. So, without further ado, let's just take people to number 10.
Alright.
So, number 10 is Drake.
Yeah.
Aubrey Drake Graham, better known as Drake, is a Canadian singer, rapper, record producer, and songwriter. Drake joined with Lil Wayne's record label Young Money Entertainment in 2009. Many people believe that he has taken over Wayne and many other famous artists as the finest of all time. Furthermore, it is obvious that Drake has been hip-hop's number one trailblazer since his debut in 2009. Despite being Canadian, Drake is one of the top-selling male musicians in the United States. So is he supposed to be at number 10?
I don't know. See, I'm from the Drake era, like the Drake generation. So I would probably put him way higher, but higher meaning like closer to number one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, man. I don't know. But what are we going off of? Like sales, impact,
sales,
and stuff like
impact,
that?
Maybe we can put in awards Nyana, here and there, but not really.
I mean, if that's the case, then I guess you'd have to take him all the way to number one then, right?
Okay.
He sold more than Jay-Z, right?
Yes. So
definitely more than
I was Jay-Z. Actually surprised when I saw him at number 10. I was like, okay, fine.
I thought maybe this was going off of just like legacy, you know? If you're talking about legacy and like shifting the culture and having their name stay for that long, then yeah, like the guys like Tupac, Biggie, they all have to be way down there, and then Drake can come in like 10, you know? Because these guys influenced a whole lot of us, man. A lot of us started rapping because of these guys. Not a lot of us can say that about Drake right now, like in this room. I mean, I know I'm the only guy that raps, but like, do you know what I mean?
Not
like, if you think about hip hop, you think about Wayne, you think about people like Jay-Z and stuff like that. So I don't know.
Yeah, I'm not gonna argue. I'm not gonna say anything because when it comes to hip hop, I'm a little bit clueless about some things. So I'm just gonna let you, Jay, tell us if he's supposed to be there or if it's not supposed to be there. So you don't agree that he should be at number 10?
No. I'm young, man. I'm from 97. I feel like he should be at least like number 5 on this list. At least.
Mm. Okay, number 9, we have Nas. If you're looking for the best lyrical alive, Nasir bin Oludara Jones, better known as Nas, is your man. Nas is one of the few rappers who has had 8 straight platinum and multi-platinum album released. However, that is not the only feature that distinguished him as one of the finest. Nas is a fantastic storyteller. He's known as the king of the street anthem, and his music has impacted a few generation of MCs. So he's right.
What? Like, what's my take?
Uh-huh.
Hey, see, this is where I fall short now, because I don't really know a lot of Nas, you know? I was too young to listen to Nas.
Okay, we're just going to take that.
Is there anyone else that we can get here, like...
Who knows anything about Nas?
Yeah. Or Biggie. Or Jay-Z.
Anyone
or
in
Pac,
here?
Or Rakim.
Anyone? Can you help us? Anyone know?
I'm too young for this.
But apparently it's like...
I know all these people for sure. Like, I know them, yeah. But like... Enough to be able to say, no, this guy deserves to be above the other guy? No, I don't. Yeah, people are going to hate me, dog. You don't understand. The backlash from this could be severe, bro.
But it's it's your opinion. I'm like, okay, but fine, fine. Rakim, so we're just going to skip him because also me, I don't know him. Yeah. I just saw him like, okay. But someone number seven. This is the big
Kendrick.
Yeah. Kendrick Lamar.
Also should be way down there, man. He should be like closer to number one.
For me, he should be number two.
Hey, that makes sense.
Yeah, it should be number two.
Yeah, that makes
because,
sense.
Because I feel like they should have just added J. Cole on number eight. And then
yeah, it's Kendrick, weird. You made me notice that Cole is not on here, and that's weird, man.
Yeah, that's
Cole should
the
definitely
thing.
Be on here.
How can you say the best rappers of all times and J. Cole is not even there?
I wish the person that wrote this was here to explain why he put this list together like this, you
yeah,
know?
Yeah, and again, Ye is not even here. Kanye is not even on this list. So at number six, we have the one and only Notorious B.I.G.
Do I think he's
that?
Supposed to be up there?
Yeah.
I think lower also. You know, you ask people about anything about hip-hop, they just say Tupac and Biggie, bro. That's where it started.
Yeah, that's where it actually started.
And even though I'm not from that era, I wouldn't dare say he shouldn't be in the top three because I know...
So you mentioned a bit about Drake being one of the people who actually inspired you to start rapping.
Wayne inspired me to start rapping, Lil Wayne and T.I. But like, shortly after that, when I was already getting like the hang of just writing songs, complete songs for like the hook, the verse and stuff like that, I started listening to Drake, and Drake is like very versatile. He'll hit you with like he'll bar out in the verse, and then in the hook he'll sing, and that was really cool, just like featuring yourself. So I listened to a lot of Drake also.
And you actually have a song with T.I. Yeah, someone you grew up
learning. Yeah, isn't that wild? That's crazy, right?
Yeah, bro, dream to come true. So, Lena, if you're out there listening, the person that I want to feature in my song when I start rapping one day. Not now, but yeah, maybe one day after this show, I'm the next DC or something like that. So, let's say you had a chance to actually make up your own list from 10 until 6.
From 10 to 6?
Yes. Who would you put?
All right. At 10... I'd put, at 10, I'd put someone like Cole, maybe? I'd put Cole at 10.
J. Cole, number 10.
Yeah, I'd put Cole. I'm looking at the other people that I still have to put later down there, you know? Cole would be up there. By number 10. I don't know who's number 10, dog. It's like I'm giving them the lowest spot on this list. I don't want to... You know what I mean? But maybe Cole would be up there for me. Or maybe, you know what? Actually, Royce the 5'9". Royce the 5'9" would be... You don't even know who that
I
is, do
don't
you?
Don't even know him.
Yeah, so that's one of Eminem's signees. He has... He signed this crew called Slaughterhouse. Four guys that rap. Joe Budden, Joel Ortiz, Crooked Eye, and Royce the 5'9". I think Royce the 5'9" should definitely be up
there. I have no idea who you're talking about. I'm over to all of them.
Stuff, you know what I mean?
Oh, okay, brag. Now did I brag. I'm at number 9.
So Royce at number 9. I will put... I agree with you. Cole should be at like number 8. So I leave Cole for number 8.
Okay.
But at number 9, I'll put... Let me put Crooked Eye. You should actually listen to some of these people. Like when you get a chance.
Definitely.
They're crazy. Like they're insane. It's the way people just like sleep on them is nuts to me. But yeah, I put Crooked Eye at number 9.
Number 9.
Yeah.
Number 8.
No, actually no, sorry.
Okay, fine.
Yeah, I understand. This person had time to put this list together. I'm doing this on the spot, so it's
save your best people for
okay, number 10, Royce the 5'9", number 9, Busta Rhymes, number 8, J. Cole. Number 7, I put Juice WRLD.
Mm-hmm.
I have my reasons.
Mm-hmm.
I put Juice WRLD in number... What was that? Number
7.
Number 7, okay, yeah. Number 6, I'll put... Let me see if I can get someone from there. Yeah, I'll put Kendrick at number 6.
Kendrick at number 6?
Kendrick at
6,
yeah.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, Ashile Lutri Lelistiae from 10 up until 6. We're actually going to continue with that list. Because number 1, guys, I can't wait to hear his reasons. Number 1, but for now, just stay tuned to your favorite show, The Ultimate Drive, right here on SMU FM 97.1.
This is the hottest station in Swahili.
I line?
Because I think this is the
SMU FM 97.1, the ultimate voice, airborne.
The ultimate voice on health. This is SMU FM Sports.
On the sports front this afternoon, Andrew McDonald has been appointed as head coach of Australia in all three formats for the next 4 years. That's 2 months after the shock departure of Justin Langer. And that's after McDonald oversaw their Test Series victory in Pakistan in a caretaker capacity. The 40-year-old former Test all-rounder had served as an assistant under Justin Langer since 2019, and he then took the reins in Pakistan after Langer declined the offer of a short-term contract extension and resigned. In rugby news, the Currie Cup Premier Division match between the Sharks and Bulls, scheduled to take place in Durban on Saturday afternoon, has been cancelled due to the heavy flooding in KwaZulu-Natal and the considerable loss of life and infrastructure damage across the province. The two teams have agreed to cancel the encounter. And as there is no alternative option to reschedule the match, the result will be declared a draw and the log points will be shared with each team awarded 2 points. And in Champions League quarter-final action this evening, two second-leg games coming up. It's Liverpool who won the first leg against Benfica 3-1. And this evening they will host Benfica at Anfield in England. And in Madrid, it will be Manchester City visiting Atletico Madrid after City won the opening leg 1-0. And that is your Wednesday afternoon world sport.
The ultimate force, one health. This is SMU FM Sports.
Let me in your tempo, show me what you into. It could be so simple, black and white, yeah. You come first like Rindu, I see all potential. It could be so simple, yeah. Like black and white, yeah.
I tell you some, I show you some, I buy you some, put you on some. Be the hand that catch your tears and still be your shoulder and and if they can't be stopped from falling, help you get over that, I'm your bitch. You need to cross over and change how you live. I know something got you stiff. I got a lot of this love to give. I want you to call dibs. I got some land inside of my ribs. Beating for you, can you hear? And just like any home, you gotta pay your bills and promise not to disappear. I got a list. One, never give up on you or me or us. Two, you gotta be patient with me like I'm patient with you. I don't like to be rushed. Three, these pretend to be happy for you. You gon' have to learn to call a bluff. Cool, cool. Four, nah, you got it. I know you the one. We the perfect two. Future with you. Bright as my teeth. Long as bamboo. Walked in the room. Caught my view. And I just knew that was my cue to walk right through. Extend my hand just like real gentlemen do. Cause I'm well raised and I'm well groomed. Hi, I'm Boo. Nice to meet you.
Let me in your tempo, show me what you into. It could be so simple, black and white, yeah.
You come first like Rindu, I see your potential. It could be so simple, black and white, yeah.
Don't make it complicated.
I'll be your piece, you be my baby.
Cut off my from my face, yeah.
Black and white, yeah.
You be putting it down on me in my bed, on your stairs. When we love it, you know we don't care. All my like wine. Say ain't no got your all bumping like I fall in love deeply when I look in your eye. Fantasy the way you carry me, Mariah.
Let me in your tempo, show me what you into. It could be so simple, black and white, yeah.
You come first like Rindu, I see your potential. It could be so simple, black and white, yeah.
Don't make it complicated.
I'll be your piece, you be my baby.
Cut off my from my favorite.
Black and white, yeah. Black and white, yeah.
What's all the playing around for? Just tell me what you down for. I'm G'd up like the ground floor. I couldn't be down more. Wherever did your crown go? You queen and you a nano. Drop it like it's for download. Link in the bio. I think that you're heavenly sent. Or better yet, girl, you make heaven make sense. That's why your heart got a fence. You let me in and you won't need that defense. An angel told me you gave heaven a sin.
Let me in your tempo, show me what you into. It could be so simple, black and white, yeah.
You come first like Rindu, I see your potential. It could be so simple, black and white, yeah.
Don't make it complicated.
I'll be your piece, you be my baby.
Cut off my from my favorite.
Black and white, yeah. Black and white.
Welcome back to SMU FM. It is 35 minutes after the hour, 5 o'clock, and you're still tuned into the Ultimate Drive. Since I'm going to this, so before we continue, got a question. It's going to get on the top 5. So setting. We're just going to play one voice note. Because, yeah, people are screaming. I'm going to freestyle. And I'm going to tell that voice note, guys. It's called Before Kebo Laiwa Pila Pila.
What's up, Nasty? We are some of your biggest fans out there on the window.
Yes, sir.
And we're asking you to freestyle, man. Yeah. So when you look by the window and then you hear this voice, though, please, freestyle.
Freestyle!
Freestyle! Come on.
So what do you have to say?
I'm so sorry, man. I can't do a freestyle, though, you know. Well, he's celebrating. I don't think he heard me.
At the show.
I'll do it at the show. No, I got you at the show. I promise at the show. Yeah, let them come and do a freestyle, man. Make this interesting, you know?
Montemo, is there anyone who can rap?
Can they hear me right now?
Yeah, they can actually hear you. Who can rap?
Who can rap out there?
Do a freestyle?
Who can rap out there? Who can rap? Who raps?
Yeah,
no,
actually.
Who raps out there?
Who's a rapper out there?
The lag, so they can't hear you.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Let's just get the lag to get in.
They're thinking about it.
Girls, who can rap on the other side? Who can rap?
All right, can you guys hear me?
No, they can't rap.
They can't hear me. How do you know this? They'll just get in here and scream.
They are fast.
Oh, he's coming, that one, the one who...
Ah, nice.
So apparently, he can rap. So, we're just waiting for someone to come in here and rap. And I think we can continue with our top five. And at number five, we have the one and only, one of my favorites, Tupac.
Yes.
Can you put him at number five?
I think I'll put him lower, you know?
Okay.
Not even based off of what I know about him, but just like...
What is your favorite song, yeah, Tupac?
Dear Mama.
Oh.
Yeah, inspired you okay in many ways.
To be quite honest, ne, when I first heard you, I think it was on You Okay, and I related to that song so much to a point where every time when I miss my late mom, I would play it, and it was that thing you would see. You're not alone. Even people big as Nasty C have been through that. So if he can release the peanut, that is why most of the time when you release something, I'm just waiting for a song. Yeah, how. Talking about your mother or something like that. So,
it's coming, trust me.
I'm gonna get it. Because You Okay kind of made me feel okay or okay. Yeah. Mama's okay wherever she is.
Yeah, man.
So, Ashe Abuti.
My condolences.
Thank you. Abuti?
How are you? I'm good. How are you doing?
I'm also good. So, you can rap?
Yeah.
Come on, man. Let the man introduce himself, man. Tell him your name, though.
Okay, I'm sorry.
Tell him your name,
Aji. Oh, my name is Phakamile.
Let's go.
Yeah, and what are you studying?
I'm studying medical microbiology.
Okay, medical micro.
Salute, man.
Yeah.
Shout out, man.
So you can do it?
Yeah, I'm nervous. I ain't gonna lie.
Do your thing, dog. Get the people what they want, man.
Bro, but I wanted to hear you freestyle.
This is your court right now, dog. I'm in your city, so to say. You know what I mean?
Okay, man.
The floor is yours. Start rapping.
Okay.
Give me, man, a beat. Don't you want a beat or something? No beat. Acapella.
Acapella. Okay. Let's go. Okay. None of these niggas are getting close to me. When I speak, every line is a mix of coke and lean. Notice me, my skill, ill shit, came with no receipt. I'm steady killing niggas at will, if you're poking me. Sunday school drop, I reading the Bible like a comic book. Pistol whipping demons and now the devil's becoming shook. They say ignorance is bliss, nigga, why they do? And now you drowning in my piss, why the fool? When it comes to hoes, I fuck like a lieutenant. That's why I get more hoes than a petrol attendant.
Yeah, watch the words. That's hard. You gotta watch the words.
Watch the words. The words.
I'm careless and I tell it, you messing with the manners. For me, your wife isn't dressing, now you're second guessing your status. I keep my punchlines lined up like Thanos' chin. And when it's crunch time, they know I make it slow. Witness in the middle of wheelchair, doing the back flipping. If you gossip, go sip my piss and get off my A.
There we go.
There we go.
Ain't gonna lie, it's hard being a foul child. I almost cussed, but
Yeah.
Can I?
You got it.
No.
Ain't gonna lie, it's hard being a foul child. My test was found inside the mouth of someone else's spouse. Emotional tactical foul when hobby found. I no longer wanna go around. Some hard nigga bust. Shit.
Never. You gave him too much.
Like at this point, I'm starstruck. Like, can I get your autograph or something? Man.
Just try, man.
Nah, you're dope, though. You're really dope, man. I really like what you're doing, bro.
Thank you, man. I look up to you, though. You know.
And what you're studying, I could never. You're balancing that with rap. That's crazy, man.
Bro, we just tried. You know.
That's crazy, man. Salute, man. I tip my hat to it, man.
Nah, shout out.
Oh yeah. You didn't say your rap name, man.
Pax, I go by Pax. Well, I've got that red.
I was gonna say Pac-Man.
For real, bro.
I'm telling you. Think about it. I'm telling you.
All right, man. Shout out. Oh, by the way, I got that rap name from my grandmama. Anyway, so.
That's fire. Man.
There we go. The man has a story already, man.
Oh, we love it, man.
Nah, shout out, man.
Yeah, so, shout out to you. Sir. Thank you so much for coming.
Thank you for your time, man. Thank you, definitely.
I'm Erava Murito SMU. Okay.
There are
two more
Ya ruta, ya tlhotlheletsa, ya sedimosetsa, ibile ya itumedisa. SMU FM, re mmogo, now ready.
SMU FM 97.1, the ultimate voice ever.
Welcome back, Murito SMU FM. It is 1744, and we are left with four people on the list. And at number four, we have Eminem.
I don't lie, I was going to take him all the way down to number one.
Oh, okay.
I know people might think I feel different on the inside, but it's facts. Yeah, I think Eminem is the best rapper in the world.
He's actually one of the best. He's actually one of the few musicians who has succeeded reaching a broad audience with census-friendly songs about murder, rap, drug addiction, conveyed into a thought-provoking manner.
Yeah, those songs, the deep songs, the super, super rappy, super barry songs. Like, he kills everything. Freestyles, like, off of the top of the head type thing. Crazy. Relatable.
Very relatable. Yeah. At number three, we have Jay-Z.
I would take him... Actually, yeah, number three is fine. For me, considering the people that I've actually listened to.
Yes.
Yeah, he's fine at number three.
Number two, Lil Wayne.
Exactly, that's... If you're talking about who influenced me, I would swap those two around. But if we're talking about who's the best rapper, then Eminem is definitely number one. I think even Wayne would agree. I'm sorry. I think he would, though.
Yes. And the moment everyone has been waiting for, according to Amy, the number one rapper of all time, Opadilembo J. Cole, Bo Lil Wayne, Bo Jay-Z, Bo Eminem. According to her, Juice WRLD is at number one.
Yeah. I don't know, Juice WRLD is an amazing rapper, man. And the stuff he could do, like, off the top of the head, with anything you pointed at him, and you just throw random words at him, and he would rap, like, make it make sense. That was crazy. But I don't know if I'd put him above Eminem.
Because, like, people before him, those are goats.
Yeah, man. Yeah.
And at number one, Juice WRLD.
Yeah, it's no disrespect to him, but I put him, at least he's in my top 10 for sure, though. Like, no question.
But not at number one.
Not at number one, no, no. Nah.
So, your number one would be...
Eminem.
Eminem.
Number two would be Wayne.
Mm-hmm.
Number three would be Jay.
Mm-hmm.
Number four, who did I put at number four?
We haven't discussed that one. We only did like from 10 until 6.
Okay, yeah.
At number four?
At number four, I would put... I already put Busta Rhymes all the way up there, no?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, maybe not him. Yo, Mos Def. I put him up there. I forgot about all the freestyles of his I used to watch. Yeah, Mos Def.
Okay, number five.
Number five, I will put... Damn, man. Give me some names, man. Throw some names in the air, I'll tell you. Nah, not a player. Nah. I mean, I love those guys, though, but nah. Ish. That guy was also, his storytelling was like impeccable, though, but he couldn't make songs for people. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, he was
too conscious. Yeah, not, yeah.
Dr.
You know?
Dre, Ice Cube.
As a, yeah, not a rapper. Come on, man. But, as a producer. Yeah, definitely. As a producer, put him on number one all the way through 10. He's there. Like, you know what I mean? In some way or another, he's there, bro. Like, but give me a rapper, man. 50 Cent.
50 Cent,
yeah.
At number five.
My man, he doesn't agree. He doesn't agree.
Why did you agree? I didn't agree, I'm saying. Okay.
50 Cent can rap about murdering someone right now. He'll make a song for the babies right now and it'll work. You know what I mean?
So, the baby is not on your list, Pilipi.
The baby? Not on this list, no. He's on my head like a...
Okay.
Give me like a hit makers list. I might throw the baby in there and stuff like that. But like greatest rapper of all time, dog. Nah, not the baby.
Yes. Let's continue. Since you know that we are Health and Sciences University, we have 5 questions for you.
Okay.
About body parts and whatnot.
I will fail, but okay. It's okay. I'll try.
So the first one is, which organ has 4 chambers?
It's the heart.
Okay.
Oh, come on now.
In which body part can you find the femur?
I don't even know what a femur is. What is that? It's a bone.
Next question.
It's in the neck.
The neck.
I don't know, man. I don't know.
So, what is your body's largest organ?
Largest organ?
Mm-hmm.
Wait, don't. Actually, let me actually try. Guys, come on, man. Have some faith in me, don't.
Yeah, we... You got this.
Wait.
You got this.
Watch me. Is it wait, say the question one more time. What is the biggest organ or
largest organ?
Okay. Is it something like a give me at least 2 tries or 3 at least.
Listen to the people outside.
What?
Listen to the giving you answers.
No, don't give me. Okay, is it the kidney? No. Not the kidney. Skin.
You guys are not supposed
skin is
to
an organ.
Yeah,
Skin is an organ? Skin is an organ.
That is crazy. I did not know that.
Okay. Nah,
I was going to fail.
So,
I was for sure never going to guess that one. Are they just reacting to it now?
So, okay. Another one is, what kind of cells are found in the brain?
You know what's crazy? You know what's crazy? I did biology in high school, bro. But it's like, as soon as I passed my matric, I forgot everything. Like, I just left everything behind, you know? And yeah, they covered a little bit of this stuff. I know not, like, in detail like it is now.
No, you're not the only one. Most of us did CPF in high school. Creme, pass, and forget.
Okay, give me a clue. Give me, like, the first letter or something like that, you know?
First letter is N.
Is what?
N.
N?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, neural something? Oh, right? Well, it's in that ballpark, no?
Okay, before we give you answers...
How do you say it, though? Say it.
We're going to give you answers.
Okay, okay, okay.
Right. The last one is, which bone are babies born without?
A boner? No.
Didn't you say bone?
What bone? A what?
A bone that babies are not born without.
I don't know, man. I didn't know that was a thing. Babies are born without a bone, and then what bone is it, man? Okay, wait. One of my guys will try, and it counts as my point.
Yeah.
Huh? Give me a clue, bro.
I hurt
the knee bone. That's not even a thing. Oh, babies don't have kneecaps.
So.
Babies don't have kneecaps.
Yeah, she's actually going to give you the answers
okay,
to that.
Okay, there we go.
So the first question was, which organ has four chambers? And you did say the heart. That
yes.
was correct.
Yeah, I remember that.
Second question was, in which body part can you find the femur? Right?
The femur?
And you said the neck. It's the leg.
I don't know what a femur is, guys. That's the problem here.
It's a leg bone.
It's a leg bone.
Leg bone. Oh. Right. Then the third question was, what is your body's largest organ? Right. And you said the kidney, the skin.
Yeah.
Yes, it is an organ, and it is the largest organ.
That's crazy.
Yes. And then the fourth question was, what kind of cells do you find in your brain? And you said?
I said it, but I don't remember how I said it. But.
It starts
but I got
with an
it
N.
Right.
It mm-hmm. starts with an N.
Yeah,
again.
I was in there.
Yeah, he got it right.
Neuro something.
Neurons.
There we go. Yeah, yes. That's what I said, man.
The last question is, which bone are babies born without? It's definitely the kneecap.
Okay, so I got 3 out of 5. That's,
mm-hmm.
I made it. I made it. It's not bad, but I made it.
It's a pass.
This is how I made it through high school. There it is. That was fun, man.
60%.
Yeah.
Way to humble me right there. Thank you, guys. I appreciate it.
But you know we are a health and sciences university.
No,
we
I know.
We
that
just had to ask you those questions.
Nah, that was dope.
So, we are about to end the show, guys. Lena ke batlo re efela ke nyakore a nemo Lena. And then my brothers are busy sending me messages. It's no fetsa. Bring him to our house. Hey, we have food and whatnot. Guys, he's busy. So, my brothers, I know they're listening. Hey, next is here, Ubis.
Lena ke apeile, hey? But yeah, I mean, I did cook, so you know.
So you.
I don't understand. First of all.
Yeah, he doesn't understand.
It's okay.
I'm gonna explain.
She cooked. I know she said she cooked.
Yeah, she cooked.
Where's this food, though? We're hungry.
In her room.
How?
Go get your food, girl.
She has no
body left. Boa, she like.
I was playing. Marakiatiba kubo amira kona didiju.
Kokai. Go ahead, very excited part, guys. We only sell quarters at my house. And then if you're allergic to quarters, don't come to my house. So, Nasty C, thank you so much for coming.
Thank you, man.
So,
dope.
What can people expect from you from now?
A whole lot of music. I want to drop a lot like songs with a lot of the artists that I'm going to be going on tour with on this campus tour. So, it's like, it's going to be a lot of upcoming artists that you guys haven't really discovered. You might have heard some of them, but they're really dope, man. And I feel like they deserve to be seen and heard, you know. So this whole tour is just about putting them on and stuff like that. And it's really dope what we did with my guy here.
Yeah,
Man, you know,
he is good. He is
yeah,
good.
Man. So I wanna do something very similar to that on the night of the tour. So it's gonna be like I wanna have a little podcast situation going on at the venue type thing, and like all the radio hosts from these campuses that I go to, you know, you guys can. I don't know, just be on there and just chill and just talk whatever you want to, you know. I want to take talk, you know. Are you the guy for that? I got you.
Me, I'm coming.
Yeah, so I want to do something like that, you know. And I want it to be open. I want anyone to be able to just come through and sit down and talk about how they're finding the show, how the experience is, and stuff like that. You know, it's not just going to be alcohol and music the whole night.
Yes, so Moreto SMU FM, that was Nasty C. At the beginning, I thought I'm going to faint when he got in here, but then he's just a humble man.
Yeah, man.
So me, I'm a huge fan. Now I can go home and scream and tell my parents that I'm famous. You can, like, if Kontokwale naga autograph, you can come and get it from me. Like, guys, Akuko Izukuba is superstar. Like, I am the superstar right now. I am the So Moreto SMU FM, that was all we had for you today. It is 17:56, and from Nagalo to the Khono. So let's talk about something else. Come on, let's have a discussion. Let's discuss something else.
This is the hottest station in Swahili.
Scream that you hate me when I know you don't. It's okay, I fucked up so much I'm still surprised you don't. What's your plan? To love me forever like you promised in 11th grade, and never break that promise even though I didn't hesitate. I owe you a rose for every breath you take. I owe you all the love God invested in heaven, and then a necklace that say you come before second place and make up for the empty space I left.